Tesla may introduce a new entry-level Model Y configuration for the 2023 model year. According to reports, Tesla is planning to offer a standard-range all-wheel drive Model Y with 4680 batteries manufactured at Gigafactory Texas. The new 2023 Model Y has been approved by the Environmental Protection Agency. Welcome to Tech Heaven, and in this video we'll take a look at how Tesla prepares to launch 4680 standard range AWD Model Y for 2023. The EPA updated their database with 3 certificates of conformity for the 2023 Model Y. According to EPA records, Tesla submitted an application for approval of these Model Y configurations on September the 30th and received certificates of conformity on October the 19th. The range ratings for the 3 new versions have yet to be released by the agency. Tesla built standard-range all-wheel drive Model Ys at Gigafactory Texas in April, making them exclusively available to employees due to battery constraints. The vehicle had a range of 279 miles, but was sold for around $60,000, which was a steep price for the range offered. It's been speculated that Tesla built this limited-edition Model Y with the much-anticipated 4680 cells. The fact that it was only available to Tesla employees could imply that the vehicle used the company's new 4680 cells. Tesla employees, including senior VP of powertrain Drew Bolino, drive a 4680 Model Y. Tesla is producing 4680-equipped Model Ys at Gigafactory Texas, but is primarily delivering 2170-equipped Model Ys to customers because the 4680 battery program is still in its early stages. Tesla's 4680 cells could be mass-produced by the end of the year. Panasonic president and CEO Kazuo Tananobu stated that Tesla's 4680 cells will enter mass production in Japan in May 2023. Tesla has worked closely with suppliers such as Panasonic to develop prototypes in preparation for mass production in 2023. This also corresponds to Cybertruck production timelines, which are expected to begin in mid-2023 and reach mass production by the end of 2023. When Tesla unveiled its 4680 battery technology at its Battery Day event in 2020, the company made a point of emphasizing how its next-generation cells could lead to vast production efficiencies, weight savings, and increased power. Tesla has been tight-lipped about the actual benefits of 4680 cells, especially when compared to the 2170 cells used in the Model Y produced in the Fremont factory and Gigafactory Berlin. Tesla discontinued the Model 3 Long Range earlier this year due to high demand, and it was sold out for 2022. It is encouraging to see that Tesla intends to resume vehicle sales with the 2023 model year. The Model S received their certificate of conformity on September the 15th, while the Model 3 trim levels were approved for sale on September the 22nd. On September the 27th, the Model X configurations were approved. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic, surprisingly, the Model Y was not on the EPA's list. While the vehicle still has approvals for the 2022 model years as a result of the launch of manufacturing at Gigafactory Texas early this year, Tesla is more than likely to have the vehicle examined by the EPA. The same is true for the Model S plate. The EPA has most likely not yet tested these vehicles. But the agency did not respond immediately to our inquiry about whether it had received applications for any Model Y trim or the Model S plate. Elon stated that Tesla has enough battery cells to produce 1.5 million cars this year. We're producing a good number every week, and I believe we'll be in high-volume production by the end of the year. It's always difficult to predict because there's so much new technology. What's the slope of the S-curve on the ramp? And except for that, I'm confident that we'll reach a high production rate. However, we won't be able to confidently reach a high production rate until the end of this year. However, this has no effect on our vehicle output. We have enough battery cell supply from suppliers to build 1.5 million cars this year. So it is not a constraint on output, but it will be significant next year. Panasonic has been developing the 4680 battery for about a year and a half, and it has not been easy. According to the executive, developing the new batteries has required an enormous amount of stamina. This is due to the fact that creating 4680 batteries is not as simple as enlarging existing cells. Tadanobu stated that altering the entire shape of the cell required considerable nerve, and Panasonic didn't know how they would be received by Tesla. Fortunately for Panasonic, Tesla is said to have acknowledged the Japanese firm's work on the 4680 batteries. Tesla has reportedly determined that Panasonic's 4680 cells are viable because they meet the performance requirements of the American electric vehicle manufacturer. This is encouraging news for Panasonic's 4680 program, given that Tesla is also ramping up production of its own 4680 cells. Some attendees at the Cyber Rodeo were surprised to see that some of the Model Ys in the Giga Texas complex were listed as Standard Range AWD. This was quite surprising, given that Tesla had not announced the vehicle and it was not available on the company's current Model Y order page. Having said that, Cyber Rodeo attendees noticed that the vehicle appeared to have a range of 279 miles. Surprisingly, these observations corresponded to a Model Y variant that was added to the EPA website earlier this year. There were few details available about the mysterious Model Y, though the variant was listed with a range of 279 miles. This fueled speculation that Tesla was planning to introduce a new standard range version of its best-selling all-electric crossover. These appear to have been confirmed recently, as an email reportedly sent by the company indicated that the Model Y standard range dual motor AWD is now available for purchase, albeit only for employees. In a Reddit comment, longtime Tesla podcast host Ryan McCaffrey stated that he had seen the company email, and Tesla fan blog Electrek stated the same. The Ride the Lightning podcast host and the EV fan blog both stated that the Model Y standard range AWD would cost $59,990. The Tesla Model Y costs $59,990 and has a range of 279 miles per charge. It has a top speed of 135 miles per hour and a 0 to 60 mile per hour time of 5 seconds. In comparison, Tesla currently lists the Model Y Long Range AWD at $62,990, which is only $3,000 more than the standard range AWD variant. The Model Y Long Range has an EPA estimated range of 330 miles per charge and a 0 to 60 mile per hour time of 4.8 seconds. While the base variant Model Y for nearly $60,000 is undeniably expensive, the vehicle is likely to be quite popular. Unlike the Chinese-made Model Y, which is only available in rear-wheel drive, the Texas-made Model Y standard range has two electric motors. The car also has Tesla's 4680 battery cells, which are at the cutting edge of the company's technology. These advancements, to some extent, may help justify the Model Y standard range AWD's price. Before vehicles can be sold by manufacturers and driven by consumers, the EPA must issue a certificate of conformity. Vehicles are not legally permitted to enter the market unless they have a certificate of conformity. The EPA tests vehicles for a variety of reasons, the most important of which is the vehicle's ability to meet emissions and fuel economy standards. Unfortunately, some automakers have attempted to cheat their way out of emissions compliance, with Volkswagen's Dieselgate scandal being one of the most publicized in recent memory. Despite the fact that electric vehicles do not have a tailpipe or run on a combustible liquid, the EPA still tests them every year to ensure they meet standards. EV manufacturers are required to disclose almost every detail about the vehicle's powertrain, battery capacity, charging specifications, and range ratings. Manufacturers are preparing to launch new model years into their fleet as 2022 comes to an end, and these vehicles must be recertified before they can be shipped to customers. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. But before that, we'd like to know whether you are excited for this launch. Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.